Hello, this is Dr. Ned Hallowell coming to you from my dining room in Arlington, Massachusetts. For as long as I can remember, I've been looking for a better term for ADHD than ADHD. It's really not a deficit, but a wandering. Hyperactivity is often not present. I don't see it as a disorder, more as a trait. And so it's not a good term. Plus, it's just a big mouthful of syllables. And yet I haven't been able to come up with a term that suited very well until last summer at the course I do on Cape Cod every summer. I'll be doing it again this summer. If you'd like to come in August, go to cape.org. It's a week-long course. It's really a lot of fun. The health editor from KQED was there. Her name is Carrie Feibel, and she offered us the following term, and I'm so grateful to her. Carrie Feibel from KQED suggested the following term. It's the acronym VAST, and it stands for Variable Attention Stimulus Trait. Variable Attention Stimulus Trait. And what I love about it is, first of all, the condition is vast, and it really imparts the vastness of this condition. It takes in so much. Instead of just being a list of, you know, 9 symptoms, it's a vast condition. And it highlights the 2 most important variables, attention and stimulus. You know, ADD folks are drawn to high stimulus. They're always seeking high stimulus in one way or another. And so both John Rady and I love this term, VAST. VAST, variable attention stimulus trait. And as long as the publisher agrees, we're probably going to entitle our next book VAST. That won't be for another year or two, but we're starting to use it, and it also gets us away from the disorder. Now, don't get me wrong. I know this condition can be a disorder, but it can also, if you manage it right, be an asset in your life. And so, as I see it, the disorder is a subset of the trait. You know, if you don't manage it right, it can be a terrible disorder. It can ruin your life. But if you do manage it right, it can be quite a wonderful thing to have. And so, Russ Barkley has certainly proven beyond any shadow of a doubt that this condition can be terribly destructive, and crippling, and indeed lethal. But if you learn how to manage it, if you learn how to ride this bucking bronco, it can take you to tremendous success, as it's done for Tim Armstrong, the CEO of Oath, which is the combined AOL and Yahoo, or for David Neeleman, the man who founded JetBlue Airlines. In any case, it is vast in its components. It is vast, it is complicated, it is incredibly interesting. I'm still learning about it. But I wanted to share with you this new term given to us by the very imaginative Carrie Feibel at KQED. Thank her. And I'd invite you to let me know what you think of it. What do you think of VAST? If you want to email me, drhallowell@gmail.com, I'd love to hear from you. This is Dr. Ned Hallowell, wishing you all a very good day.